guys. Scenery is a little bit better here. We are hanging out in a spot that's near and dear to my heart. If any of you knew me from the past or know me now personally, you'll know how important Heartland Lodge, Harpole's Heartland Lodge here in Ebo, Illinois, is to me. I cut my teeth here and in the industry, and this kind of started, capped off at that point what I thought was a passion, but you know, little did I know it was nowhere near the cap of my career, but only just the start. Don't get a lot of time to get back here. Feel pretty blessed on this trip here, this client trip here in April, to be able to take some time off the road in between client visits here and get back and visit. This video, what we're going to chat about today, is just that experience and how to, you know, take that and move that into your whitetail you know, properties for the good, and you know, learn from the experiences, past experiences. Now, you know, coming from a, you know, being born and raised in a state such as Michigan, you know, we didn't have a lot of opportunities at large mature deer, you know, back to back, if you will. Now, and or after that, then coming down here into you know, a world like Pike County and Calhoun County, Illinois, boy, what an eye opener, right? But it was a huge blessing, as far as, you know, being able to understand and connect with mature deer movements, and being able to study, you know, why they move the way they do, and what they react to. You know, how much of a manipulation factor can you do, you know, to move that in your favor. Now, you know, looking back, you know, we were obviously making a paycheck as a guide, so the more successful the clients were, the more successful you were if you took it serious like I did, and you know, the guys that we guided with here did, you know. So helped run the lodge, the whitetail division here at Heartland, with a good friend of mine for years. And over that time, like I said, we you know, we were able to, you know, to put a lot of good deer on the ground. But now looking back, boy, what 20 years has changed over the you know, what has changed over the course of 20 years, right? We actually did have the first trail camera here. I remember here at the lodge, we were part of, now I don't know if we were the first ones to actually have it or not, but I remember being part of that, that we were actually shipped one of those cameras, a 35 millimeter camera. Looking back at it, it was half the size of a computer now, and on a tripod. And we set it on the side of a bean field, and we couldn't wait to run to the town of Pittsfield here north of us, you know, a week or once or twice a week to develop that film. And now, as we're talking, you know, we get it right on our phones right here, right? Your phone's dinging, and I'll get my updates from my cameras here at 11 o'clock. It's just amazing. It's just a you know, a tool that we you know, I recommend that you don't overlook, or and I recommend taking the advantage of, because now, like I said, looking back, not that there wouldn't be any deer safe, but boy, we sure would have gave them a lot more trouble. We did very well back there, you know, back in those days for what we had, running the number of clients that we ran through the lodge here. You know, since then, they don't run near as many hunters. Quality is great over the last couple of years. Gary and his crew here at the lodge, Matt, the whitetail manager, they've done great things, and continue to do great things, and realize that, you know, high pressure isn't just high numbers. Big numbers don't mean big success, right? So that's something that we tried to keep in check years ago, and you know, the lodge learned and over the years that, you know, lower numbers works. And that goes to kind of tie into this video here, is as far as experiences, you know, some folks never get the opportunity to experience, you know, big deer mentality or mature deer mentality. And what happens is that trickles into their success or their outcome of their properties for long term. And that's kind of the whole moral of the video here, I guess, guys, is just sitting here. Was able to get off the road here for the day, in between client trips, like I said, and kick my feet up here at the lodge and in one of the two lodges, main lodges, and then Gary and the crew have got some new lodges that they've built across the road here, the ATV park and everything. So if you haven't experienced this, I recommend, if you're in the Midwest, you know, stop in and you know, into the lodge and kind of kick back, and maybe if it's just a, you know, regroup or even corporate retreat or whatever that case is, it's a good refresher. But like I said, what I'm doing this evening, got some clients to reach out to, taking some notes here, and you know, moving forward through the rest of April. I've got about halfway through our April trip here, and you know, and then followed up with a great May. But these experiences that we speak of, you know, looking back at the you know, the mature deer, one of my clients here guided two, and as far as I know, he's still the, you know, per inch is probably the biggest deer that they've ever killed here. It was a 194, 5.5 year old deer, you know, and that's dating back 20 plus years ago. Those deer aren't just under every tree, right? But what I learned from that deer and what I learned from multiple deer here, and multiple hunters that came through, we were always learning. So I feel pretty blessed, pretty fortunate to be able to bring those experiences and kind of learn from them over the years. And then, you know, moving from here back to Michigan and then having the struggle of, you know, the struggle through finding, you know, doing more and more and more homework to try to find and capitalize on those deer, not only for myself, but family and friends. And you know, to me, guys, it's been a business for years. It's been a way to keep, you know, kind of food on the table, if you will. And then over the last couple of years, I've really focused on the kids and myself, and we bought the farm in Kentucky, and we're doing, you know, tying this back in kind of full circle, if you will, getting back in the stand. Because if you, you know, if you are a guide or have a guide in the family or know a guide, most guides that, you know, are passionate about hunting don't get to hunt. It's a sad part of the deal, but they don't get to hunt as much as they would love to, and that's exactly what, you know, what happened over the years. But I don't regret that decision that I made at all. We definitely, like I said, have, you know, been able to kind of store all that and build off from all those experiences, and then being able to connect with you guys on the properties or the clients that we visit around the country, and being able to help you out on your farms and your properties. And this is where it all started, right here. We're actually in the newer lodge that wasn't here, when I was here. The old lodge is the old original lodge is just across the yard here. So a lot of experiences, a lot of memories here between you know, that front porch and the meat pole and the properties, you know, driving up and down the road and seeing, you know, seeing those properties that we used to, like I said, like we cut our, you know, I cut my teeth on here, you know, a few other close friends did as well. But like I said, one thing to kind of, I guess as a finishing note on this video here, is the experiences, you know, jot those down. I've still got notes from years ago. You know, I've still got photos. I've still got aerial maps. I've still got everything that sometimes I'll look back at and, you know, kind of, you know, shake my head and say, you know, what was I thinking? Could have done better. And then I look back at some things, pictures, and like I said, some of those old books and aerial photos that we used to print off from the NRCS office and now have at our fingertips through Hunt Stand. And, you know, all that gets collected and we learn from it. So sadly, what I see, you know, across the country as a whole is, you know, folks not learning, moving forward, still having bad access, still having bad practices as far as hunting strategies. And I can, you know, I'll be the first to tell you that the experiences that I had here 20 years ago starting my career, I do not do some of those today, you know. So not only for myself, but for clients, whether guiding or, you know, building properties for you guys and having you being the one that's, you know, actually doing the hunting as far as finding your way to the stands and navigating through those properties. So Highly recommend. I'm a huge field note guy. I have been, you know, dating back to when I was here. All that helps. You know, look at last year's experience. We talk about weather underground all the time. Weather underground is a huge, huge asset as far as being able to look back at last year's information, bringing that forward. Now, years ago, we didn't have the weather underground availability that we have now, you know, like when I was here at the lodge. But we did resource, you know, weather was a huge, huge deal, obviously, looking back and trying to write those notes down. You know, we always took the notes, and then we'd, you know, I would look back and say, okay, this deer was at this stand at this wind and this time, what's the connection, you know? And then the old days of pinning that, you know, taking those place pins and putting them on the aerial, stuff like that, color coordinating, all that stuff. But you know, not only do you guys get to benefit from my experiences of doing that, now you guys get to, you know, benefit from the more hands-on stuff right through hunt stand. And like I said, it's kind of come full circle. So, you know, as a kind of a closer here, guys, just, you know, experiences, look back, pull those notes. If you haven't been a note taker in the past, make sure that you, you know, are storing your trail cameras now, pictures, you know, organizing them and really using them to your advantage, because someday, you know, you'll be sitting in a place like this that kind of takes you back to 20 years ago, and you'll wish that you had. And you know, we wish that we had the things, you know, wish I would have had them back then like we have now. But it's all an experience. It's all a you know, a step towards the future. And that's exactly, like I said, I don't it's a huge, huge part of my past, and feel blessed to be able to be back here taking a kind of a breather this evening, and on the back on the road tomorrow with you know, more properties ahead of us. So yep, if you're down here in the area, you guys, I highly recommend, like I said, reach out to Gary and his crew here at Harpole's Heartland Lodge here in Nebo, and you won't be disappointed. A lot of things going on: ATVs, horseback riding, corporate retreats, you know, big business compared to what it was when I was here, but still the hometown atmosphere, and still that family connection that you can have here from the porches, or such as we're doing tonight on a beautiful, you know, Midwestern evening here. So appreciate you guys following along, and I got some really neat things coming our way as far as videos, and also some really, really neat properties that we're going to be on here finishing up our April trip. So look forward to seeing you guys in some upcoming videos here that we're going to be shooting from the farms here in the Midwest throughout the week, and some good tactics and strategies that we're going to touch on, some builds, some contour stuff, stuff like that. So stay tuned, guys. I appreciate your support. Thanks.